welcome back to the channel once again. For those of you who haven't been here before, don't forget to hit that subscribe button, leave us a like and a comment if you enjoy this video. Today we are with Rito. You guys should be familiar with him by now. So a while back we did a video on things to look out for when going to buy a second-hand car, and in a way this is also sort of a follow-up on that. So Rito has been looking out for an E46 for how long? I don't even know how long. And I think it's testament to the fact that, you know what, when you're looking for something specific, you know, you don't have to let up on quality, man. Wait until you find what you're looking for. So yeah, Rito, tell us more about your car.
Okay, so this is a E46 3-5A. What I like about this car is that it's not the normal four-door E46 that you get. It's actually the coupe, so it's a 3-5 CI in actual fact. Yeah.
So yeah, no, I was gonna ask, like, I know a lot of people they like the sedan version. Would you say that you prefer the CI over the sedan, or what do you like better?
To be honest, I didn't expect to find a coupe in the model. I was actually looking out for a four-door sedan instead of the coupe, because I didn't see much for sale as well, because they're not on the market a lot. But when I did see the coupe, I thought, let's go and have a look, let's check it out, and if I'm happy with it, then I'll make an offer.
Yeah, I know. And yeah, I know, it wasn't even long and then you decided to do exhaust.
Yeah.
And yeah, you guys can probably hear, it's quite loud, and we did some rolling shots, so you guys will see that as well. The car sounds really nice, even though, like, what exactly did you do with the exhaust?
So I checked out a few videos on YouTube to see what people are actually doing with the exhaust, and most of them are doing either a straight pipe from the middle box straight to the back, or they delete the middle box and the back box and then do an X pipe in the middle. So what I went for is I kept the resonator in the middle, deleted the back box at the back, instead of doing the A57mm pipe to match what's currently on the car. I did a 63 where the back box was, straight out to 76mm tail pieces.
Nice, and those tail pieces are super nice.
Yeah.
Is it loud enough, or do you want to go louder?
I don't know if there is such a thing as is it loud enough.
Yeah, no, loud enough does not exist. So, like, yeah, you drove the Golf 3 for a long time.
Yeah.
And before that, like, myself and yourself, we had quite a few Honda. Yeah, we were quite into Hondas. The 3-5 CI, the E46, it's by now it's a reasonably aged chassis. It's been out for a long time. Would you say it's still worth it still? Would you still say that it's worth the money buying an E46, and more specifically buying a 3-5 CI?
To be honest, I think that if there's a lot of it on the market, and looking through marketplace and stuff, there's if you happen, like, this is the one thing I do when I look at cars, I see what's the availability of cars on the road, because I don't want to be stuck with something where I'm going to look hard for a part.
Yeah, if something goes wrong.
So chassis wise, most of the items are interchangeable with the four door. So when it comes to the motor, when it comes to suspension and things like that, but what I have noticed is panels are quite difficult to find. So the only other car that it is compatible with is the E46 M3.
Okay.
Which is a bit pricey as well.
Yeah.
So if you're looking at OEM panels for the,
I think
the
that's
M3.
Because the CI is a little bit wider.
Yeah.
Isn't it? Yeah.
That's right.
So, like, yeah, I'm gonna try to say this. I know that it's hard to keep a car stock. So are there any future plans? Are there any other things that you want to do with the car right now?
You see, well, the car isn't really Like, I never bought it for more of a race car or anything like that. Although the performance on the car, I am happy with it. So what I do plan on doing is maybe just headers on the car, and then maybe just the look on the car, change it up. So change the front bumper to maybe the M Sport bumper, and obviously going for maybe a bigger rim as well on the car.
All right, and what's it like drivability wise?
I find it very comfortable. So before this, I used to drive a Mark 3 Golf, and I don't think there's any comparison. So.
Smooth as hell.
Yeah, so I enjoy it quite a lot.
And also, like, when you drive in the car, this is like a thing that I've noticed with the BMWs. You don't feel the age of the car, man.
Yeah, that's right. So jumping into this car, I wouldn't say like, wow, this car is from 2004 or 2003.
Yeah.
So quite happy with it.
And also, I think as much as I like the look of them, these wheels gotta go.
Yeah.
What wheels are you looking at throwing on you?
I'm still shopping around to see what looks good on the car, but I'm looking for something that I'm gonna spray black as well. Or if I don't find it in black, or if I don't find it, then I don't know. So gonna have to check.
Just like myself, before I got the E82, I only had manual cars, and they're always pretty much the same. So this is your first automatic.
That's
and like, how do you feel about the change? Like, does it nerve? Does it work on your nerves or?
It actually doesn't work on my nerves. I think that was one of the questions that I asked you before I actually went to go and look at the car. I said to you, how do you feel about changing over from manual to automatic? Yeah. I think because I haven't dailied an automatic often, I didn't know what to expect when driving the car. But to be honest, it's really not a hard thing to change over.
Yeah.
So I actually find it much more comfortable as well. The gear changes are smoother than a manual. The first few weeks that I had the car, I had like a phantom clutch. So sometimes when I would start the car, I would like try and put in a clutch and make sure it's in neutral, forgetting that it's already in park or something like that, and I don't have a clutch at all.
So I think the big question that I'm going to drop at you right now is, you had the car now for a couple of weeks.
Mm-hmm.
Do you think you made the right decision? Are you enjoying the car, or given the opportunity, would you go back and choose something else?
So that did go through my mind also, because I think like a week or two after I bought the car, I actually saw a 320B, a white one, a nice white one, for sale as well. And to be honest, in that moment that I saw the car, I felt like, you know what, a four-door actually looks very nice. Like the look of it is nice.
Yeah.
But then I just thought there is actually a lot of it on the road. Like it's
yeah, there's a lot less CIs.
There's a lot less CIs on the road, and it's more unique. So to answer your question, yes, I am happy with the car.
That's awesome. And performance wise, like, how does it feel driving the car?
Like I said earlier in the video, it's not like a hectically fast car or anything like that. But the power is there when you need it. So if a person has to decide to overtake or to just put your foot down
have
or
some fun.
Stuff like that, or have some fun, the power is there. There's no complaint about that.
Okay. And what do you think you would move on to from here? Like, what do you think would be the next step after E46 325? And also, do you think you can move away from a six-cylinder now?
To be honest, I'm actually not sure what's the next step after this. I haven't thought about that.
N54, nice.
I haven't thought about that yet. But your other question about moving away from a six-cylinder, sure, that's a tough question. I don't think
you see, like, I'm throwing that at you now because I know before this it was all four cylinders, right?
Yeah.
And you've had some interesting cars. You had a really nice Alpha as well, which was quite quick. So it's not like you haven't driven fast cars.
Yeah.
But there's just something special about driving a six-cylinder.
I don't know, man. Yeah, it is. There's just something special about it.
Yeah, I know the BMW inline sixes are amazing engines. So yeah, I think is there anything else you want to conclude with us before we end off?
Nothing else. That's about it.
So yeah, hopefully we're gonna see more of this car and of the future cars and future builds on the channel, inshallah. Shukran, but